The purpose of this tutorial series is to kind of give you an introduction to how to integrate Steam multiplayer into your GameMaker project. This episode is just going to be setting up our environment. So if you go to the repo that we posted in the links in the description, we're going to be needing GameMaker 2024. That's the latest version I'm using right now. The Steam SDK 1.55. So be sure that you're not getting the latest one, you're getting 1.55. As far as I know, the plugin that we'll be getting from GameMaker currently only supports 1.55, as far as I know, without changing anything. It probably supports later versions, but for right now, we're using 1.55, just so you know. And you'll also need Steam installed locally. Whenever you're launching your game from GameMaker and it integrates Steam into it, it will use temporarily this kind of SpaceWars Steam app ID. And so Steam will think that you're launching a Steam game. That's how it can integrate all the multiplayer and the social aspects of Steam into the game. So that's how we'll be using that. I do suggest using GitHub Desktop if you're terribly unfamiliar with GitHub in general. This will help your ability to kind of sync your version between your server and your client, because we will be running two instances of Steam on two different virtual machines, like another Windows virtual machine that we'll have running like in the background and everything. This is the easiest way I've found to test multiplayer interaction through Steam, because you need to actually get another OS environment, another Windows environment, to run Steam and to actually like launch the game on Steam networking as well. So you'll probably need another Steam account as well. You can make another one. Apparently Steam lets you make other accounts, like just like your household. You have, I could say it's your brother's, your sister. I have no idea, but anyway, that is what you'll need to set up. I'm going to go ahead and use GitHub Desktop. I've come to enjoy this quite frequently, and I'm going to clone the repository that we're going to be using. I've tried to organize this repo by branch being each episode that I'm working through. So since we're doing episode one, we're gonna pull that. But let's pull the repo first. So in GitHub Desktop, if you have it installed, go to File, Clone Repository, get the URL. We're going to paste, copy the URL from here, paste it there, and we're going to put it in a directory. I think I'll use this one since I have an empty folder there. So it will pull this whole repo into this directory. That way we can get kind of a starting point. So we've cloned the repository. We are on the main branch currently. We want to switch to episode one, and that way we can start kind of where we are starting today. Each episode that I have, in the event you're wanting to skip ahead or something like that, the branch is where the episode will start. So episode one, we're starting with this one. Episode two, we'll start with that one. It's not the end of it. So episode four, we'll start with that one, and so on and so forth. Whenever, I don't know, only have four episodes lined up so far, but when we get further in, we'll add more. But let us go ahead and do that. So we've cloned it. We have it here. Let me go ahead and find it here. So there's the repo that I've cloned. Let me go ahead and open it up. So this project is just in a base state with two rooms, a main menu room and a game room. And there's no networking whatsoever. I just wanted to give you guys a few things to get you ready. Now what we need to do is install the Steam SDK as well. We have the project ready and waiting, but we need to download the Steam SDK from here. So when you download that, it will be a zip file. You essentially just want to put the contained folder here somewhere on your system. You don't have to actually install anything. I have mine kind of outside of my project. Anywhere that you have it is fine. Just make sure you have it somewhere, because you will be now telling GameMaker where it's located when you add the extension. So we have it extracted. We have the folder somewhere nearby. We're going to go to Marketplace. I'm going to go to My Library. Now, if you don't already have this plugin added to your account, you'll need to go to the Marketplace. You'll have to log in. You'll have to search for Steamworks. This is the Steamworks extension that is on the GameMaker Marketplace here. And there'll be like an add button or something like that. Once you have it added to your account
and you're actually logged into Gmail, you can import the project here. When you import this, you only need to import, there we go, it had to download the extension. You only need to import, really, this guy here. So we're going to add this folder. And I don't know if we need this. I'm going to include it anyway, just in case. But you don't need the Steamworks demo. That's if you want to look at their own project, which I greatly encourage you to do so. If you want to learn more about this outside of what I'm going to be teaching you, because they do everything that integrates with Steam with GML. Really cool. And then if you are getting that demo, make sure you get the assets from that as well. We don't need that though. We're just using the plugin. That's all. And we're going to import that into our project. It's saying I already included it. I guess I included part of it in the GitHub repo. That's fine. So we have it. It's now here. I like having a good practice of any extension I'm adding to my Gmail project to put this drag and drop in my extensions folder. And let's close up my library folder, go back to the workspace. We are going to open up this extension, and we need to actually point the extension, point the plugin to where our SDK is located. And this will be the folder that you extracted. I extracted it here, but wherever you extracted it, make sure you're pointing it to it. Now, this also has application ID already put here. This is the infamous the Steam development game called SpaceWars. It's just an app ID on Steam that allows you to kind of develop with that app ID to be able to freely, without purchasing a license, test Steam implementation into your game. So we'll be able to do multiplayer achievement tracking, all sorts of good stuff by using their sample Steam ID. Now, I could be wrong about the achievement things. I think that part you actually need to pay to get your own application ID, or pay the $100 to get your own license and stuff. But for what we're doing with this whole tutorial series of just networking interaction, this is fine. So at that point, this is finished, and we can actually, we should be able to launch now. And that's good. Now you see that this pops up and everything, but there's a few more changes we have to do before we fully consider ourselves ready to continue. Now that we've added the Steamworks extension, we do need to make a few changes to the game so that the game can continually communicate with Steam. First, we're going to modify this object Steam that I created. We're going to add in its create event. Just something that kind of lets us know if it's initialized. We'll do if theme initialized, then show debug message Steam initialized. Those will just let us know. It'll log a little message saying, hey, Steam actually is active. Of course, you have that with that pop-up of the overlay, but this just lets you know that the actual game itself also sees that it's connected to Steam. Another thing we're going to need to do is whenever we restart the game for testing purposes, like I know a lot of game devs will use like press the R key to restart the game. We need to have a variable called is game restarting. We're going to make that false just for now. And also we're going to add a step event. And pretty much for every step, this is going to be used to kind of keep Steam updated. So this is a Steam update kind of query that the Steam object will be doing. This allows the game to continually communicate with Steam. This is just a simple function called Steam update. Now the documentation says that this should be called at least once per second, but the demo project said it needs to be called every frame. So it's kind of up to you. For laziness, I'm just going to put it here, but maybe to optimize it, we need to do like an alarm and have it like do once every 10 or 20 game frames or something like that. Let's start, but we'll leave it for here for now. Also, when we do restart the game, we're going to add a little logic here called on the R button. And I'm just going to copy it from over here. Essentially, this will set that restarting game to true and game restart. And the reason why we're doing that is because when the game ends, which when you do a game restart, technically the game triggers this game end event, we want Steam to know that it doesn't need to actually shut its service down. So I just copied and pasted this stuff here. But this is essentially when you're restarting the game. When we click R to restart the game from the beginning, we're telling Steam, don't shut down the service. Leave it running. We're just restarting the game from scratch. However, when we are shutting down the game and actually quitting it, do run Steam shutdown. Like shut down the service safely. That way, for example, if we were using Steam's live presence and it was saying you are playing a game or you are playing as a certain character in a certain level, it will also clean up all of that stuff properly. So we do need to make sure that we are issuing a Steam shutdown command when the game is closing. So this is kind of just an easy way to put that here. It's replacing some of the other logic I had here. We're actually going to disable this OBJ game and just disable that there. I press Command Control K to comment that out. We're going to say that this logic move to OBJ Steam. And this escape key button that I have bound here to where if you press the escape key, it'll quit it. We can leave that here for now. Once again, this is just a debugging thing for this title I gave you guys. Press escape to shut it down. Press R to restart it. And we'll move on from there. This project is now in a state where it's ready to kind of start programming how the server interacts and how the client interacts and stuff. So next episode, we'll deal with how to actually get these things working here. How to join a lobby, how whenever we click host lobby, it actually spawns us. And it shows up as a lobby that somebody else can join. But we're going to do that next one. So we'll see you in the next one. Plug here. I want you to try to continue moving forward, creating your own repo and pushing all this information to there. Because whenever we have more virtual machines running to have more Steam clients, we want to be able to have a means to synchronize our version of the game in GameMaker. And so if you're using GitHub Desktop, my method, I'll explain it through here. But hopefully you know how to make your own forked repo. But it should suggest that we don't have right access to the project that I provided you guys, so you can create a fork. And we do want to make a fork. I created a temporary GitHub account called Sloopy. And so we're going to fork this repository where we already have, and I don't want to contribute to the parent project, but I want it for my own purposes. You can, if you understand how that works, great, do that, and you can totally do that, but I would mostly we're doing this for your own purposes, so that you can continue. You want to do version control within your virtual machines that you have running. So we're going to do that, and we'll just say completing episode one. And it should put you to this point where now we've pushed our current changes to our repo. Now, because we forked it, it thinks we're still kind of doing... There we go. It was trying to merge with me, but you want to merge it to your main so that you can continue working from the main one is where you're working from. Just do this pull request to main, and it'll just merge it right. So now we should be working on your main branch from now. There we go. Okay. So since I did merge it to main, I switched to main and I did a pull to make sure that we were up to date because we did just merge it right there. Now, there's probably a much better way to explain all the GitHub shenanigans. I'm not trying to make this episode to explain all that perfectly. Once again, we're just trying to get us in a good state to start moving forward and having our own version, our own forked version of the repo so that we can experience this whole tutorial series going forth from the same code base. So yeah, just wanted to inject that here. See you in the next one though. All right, good luck.